I'm Terry from Invest Hong Kong, the Hong Kong Government Department for Promoting Foreign Direct Investment. Today, I'm happy to have an interview with Howard. The banking industry is experiencing rapid digitalization. Forbes Hong Kong is well known as a digital technology service provider in Hong Kong banking industry. Can you tell me how Forbes Hong Kong is positioning yourself in the fintech space?
We are the cross-border fintech thought leader, incubator and enabler. We have established footprint in the Greater Bay Area and several other jurisdictions in Asia. We specialize in the banking industry. We bridge East plus West business model and technology adoption. Our role is clear. We put together advisory and implementation. We work with central banks to shape the future of money, traditional banks to change the bank, and virtual banks to build the bank. We also work with large corporates that want to explore and leverage the power of fintech.
So what are the top one or two pain points of the banking service industry in Hong Kong? And to what extent does Forbes Hong Kong address these problems?
First, both financial institutions and fintech companies are likely competing for similar talents in the market. And likely more important is whether you can get the right talent. By right talent, we mean those who know fin, that is the banking business, and tech. Forbes has a scale of over 2,300 fintech talents, plus experienced consultants to back up the growth of the industry, and we are targeting to grow our talent pool further. The second is getting the right solution implemented. Different banks are at different positions and paces in digitalization. It is a tough task to identify and implement the most cost-effective approach and solutions to address the challenge at hand. May that be improving customer experience by means of new channel or user interface, exploring new technologies to enhance risk management, or automating processes to raise efficiency, etc. On this aspect, Forbes co-create with our clients from ideation all the way to implementation.
Most people who use e-banking will find it easy and convenient. With the launch of 8 virtual banks in Hong Kong, what's the difference between virtual banks and the e-banking system of a traditional bank, especially from technology infrastructure, user experience, and security perspectives?
From a technology infrastructure standpoint, if we compare a technology-advanced traditional bank to a virtual bank, they can be very similar. Of course, a lot of traditional banks are likely still hosting many of their machines in their own data centers, while virtual banks are likely leveraging cloud services. Another aspect would be the channel or customer touchpoint. Virtual banks are usually offering their access only through mobile applications. From a user experience perspective, there can be quite some variants. Let's pick a few examples. For customer onboarding, a virtual bank can onboard a customer within a few minutes. The customer is offered a fully functional account and virtual card that can be used immediately. For customer service, since virtual banks do not have physical branch, robo-advisor, in-app chat, or call center are the usual options that they use to interact with customers. Finally, cash withdrawal. The usual option that virtual banks use is joining existing ATM networks in Hong Kong. Some virtual banks may choose to be complete digital and leverage partnerships with digital payment services that are commonly used in the society. Finally, on security. Established banks and virtual banks are subject to the same regulatory requirements and offer same deposit protection of up to 500,000 Hong Kong dollars. The HKMA has done a good job in formulating solid cybersecurity requirements to cope with the ever-increasing cybersecurity risk. All licensed banks, including virtual banks, are required to comply with the same cybersecurity fortification requirements, with virtual banks subject to the highest standard by default. On other areas, some virtual banks even come up with innovative products that are even safer. For example, numberless card, risk-based identity and access management mechanisms, and customer behavioral risk rating.
Forbes is the expert in blockchain technology. How are you applying blockchain technology in the banking sector?
Blockchain can be adopted in a lot of different areas associated with the financial industry. For example, insurance, security, real estate, corporate financing, etc. Some banks have already pioneered the use of blockchain on trade finance. Our current focus is central bank digital currency and digital currency electronic payment. This will be the world's future of money and will transform how the financial world operates, both locally and cross jurisdictions. Stay tuned on our upcoming series on LinkedIn to know more.
Knowing that Forms Hong Kong has been expanding to several overseas markets as a cross-border fintech company, how was your experience working with these ecosystem partners like Invest Hong Kong and other fintech organizations?
Forms Hong Kong sees the unique value of Hong Kong. We are able to combine mainland's fintech expertise and capability and Hong Kong's know-how on international banking practices and regulatory requirements. The success of it also depends on our understanding of the individual country's market landscape and whether we can team up with the right partners in those markets. We are glad to have very encouraging initial successes in Thailand and Malaysia. We are thus confident to further expand our international footprint in the coming years. We are grateful for Invest Hong Kong's assistance, bridging us with passionate industry stakeholders in other countries and locations.